few nicks. That's the beauty of, and that's the beauty of boxing. That's the beauty of boxing.
Bernard,
you don't have to wait a whole year if you lose the Super Bowl or NBA championship. Think about it, y'all. Everybody here is sports fans. Boxing, you don't have to, most likely some do, you don't have to wait a whole year or two to get a shot back. If you was the top dog and somehow you came up short, you right back at the line, you right back at the... lick the lollipop again.
But isn't it important, Bernard, you haven't been a warrior and a gladiator, a guy that doesn't even eat sugar or consume sugar. How does it make you feel when you hear your fighter omit that he is now using marijuana and drinking alcohol on a regular basis?
Well, if it was not legal, I have a problem with it. But I think 90% of the people in LA and New York are smoking some kind of marijuana or taking some kind of edibles. Saying that, I say that if that's what Ryan needs for Ryan at this moment, and it doesn't affect the rules and regulation of boxing and to his ability, then we're talking something different, because he has an investment in himself and his family first, and we have an investment as the promoter. But am I concerned that Ryan is doing this every day and would do it through camp and do it the night of the fight or the day of the fight? Absolutely not. And I don't even know if he in hell again. I'm going to keep going back there. I haven't seen no smoke come out the mouth. I've seen the blunt.
In his mouth.
But have he in hell? Do we know that? So I don't know. I've seen the things. But I don't know. But one thing I can say, that Ryan Garcia will be ready come April.
Who is more likely to have inhaled, Ryan or Bill Clinton?
I mean, Mike Tyson was one of the greatest, and still one of the greatest of fights. You know, I mean, this guy behind you should know, right? He definitely should know. He all over the place. So I'm talking about him. He should know. Mike Tyson, I ain't putting this stuff out there. It's an open record. Mike talk all about fitness. Mike said he was high half the time. So at one point, you know, he had a hangover the day before the fight in Tokyo when he fought Buster Douglas. So what are we talking about? In some cases, people fight better. And I'm not saying again, Ryan inhaled. When I watched it, it didn't look like he inhaled it. I'm thinking there's a prop, because I know I was with the shenanigans. I was with the shits all the time, having you thinking I'm going to do this, thinking to do that, thinking I'm going to do this, thinking I'm going to do that. And I made a lot of people wanting to kill me for doing the things. And I had the fighter, one that hurt me so bad, he forgot his game plan. Felix Trinidad, 9/11, New York City. The whole country was telling him that he killed him because he threw our flag down. And I killed him.
What do you think about this?
This is powerful. I beat anybody want to test me with that. I challenge anybody.
Yeah, what do you think about Canelo?
Anybody.
Canelo Munguia, what do you think?
Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney is the fight that need to be respected and talked about. I will not talk about any fight until that fight is over. Going forward, when I head back to the East Coast, and then to Florida to rest up a little bit, because this fight deserved, based on two fighters that could have went anywhere else, chose to do well, chose to fight each other.
Bernard, have you watched any of the amateur matchups between Kevin and Ryan?
No, a lot of fans are going against
that was elementary school. I care nothing about what happened in the amateur.
He might have his reason. Maybe he's waiting.
I don't care nothing about what happened in the amateur.
But I think you're not getting the same test in college that they gave you in high school.
These guys can't intellect anything.
they receive and they repeat.
Anymore, you know? He's
the biggest fool in life can receive something and repeat it. Especially if you don't have any kind of education on what you're speaking about.
Ronaldo,
you just react.
Oscar, Tank seems to be fighting Frank Martin. Nexus seems to be the next fight for him.
Anyway,
it's a rumor. They've kind of been teasing it. Just, what are your thoughts on that?
We fought the amateurs.
To tell you the truth, I don't really know.
Then you telling me I'm
I've
in
heard
college,
of his name, but I really haven't.
And I should pay attention to high school.
His fights.
Why the fuck I'm in college?
I just don't know why fight him.
So why would I talk about the amateurs if we're in the pros?
A unification.
And we're in the pros with a double-digit number that we not only in the pros,
I don't know
we're in the pros as seasonable guys. That's not looked at as a prospect anymore. We looked at as what?
He's good.
Prime this era.
What does that mean like? Champions of boxing, right? Canelo
striving to be
seem to be
one of the great
facing maybe the best competition available to them. What does that say about them?
Why are we talking about boxing? Stuff that
like don't blame
because
it on the state
internet
of
reporters
blame
get
on
paid by getting interviews to take and get money. So you want to talk about bullshit? What kind of toilet paper you use?
We kind of think about dumb
shit. Y'all gotta get a good
one.
I hate on you killing some crack cocaine or fentanyl.
Tank Davis.
Y'all gotta
well.
Get a fucking job to make more money
Tank
than this bullshit because
the
question from
the
ass. And I know you gotta turn him in to get
Tank.
Money because
he's a
you.
Great fighter.
Y'all, you can't be proud of yourself. You can't be proud of yourself that you wind up this way in
even
life.
Even Devin Haney, even so. That's
but somebody
why
gotta
Ryan
do it.
For taking this fight with
they
Haney.
Don't want everybody to go to Harvard.
Willing to be
doctors. Right, you need somebody to put the trash on. You do the dirty work.
He gets mismanaged.
You're a very witty gentleman.
I think there's a fine line between mismanaged and taking care of too much.
No, he do.
See, there's a secret with promoting. There's a secret with matching up fighters. You want to match them up tough. You want to match them up lightly. You want to match them up, you know, make sure they win. My philosophy. If you're the top guy, if you're fighting at a level,
I gotta say, you're
you
very witty
fight
guy.
Elite fighters
if someone like Devin would tell
it.
You what
that's
he told Ryan,
line, you go up and down.
What are you telling him?
He said,
oh,
he did call, but he's got nonsense. Ryan
might as well be against the top guy and take your chance.
Like, I thought,
was it Holly's idea for the chair in New York? Was it your idea, Holly?
You answer that, or?
I told Ryan not to answer.
Yeah.
That's what I have to ask his dad. Do an interview with his dad between now and the fight call.
Okay.
I asked his dad, I told his dad, no, I shouldn't even answer that. It's stupid. Why get into that
correct.
Energy?
It's true, you're right.
The man hollering screaming, you saying, nah, you ain't doing a playing into it. See, when a guy do it once and twice, do you see what they're trying to do? They're trying to get in your head. They want you to get emotional. They want you to react to it.